And I vividly remember coming here and being wowed by how big the stones were and how old.
It's to tell the story of the past 100 years by the people who've been here. This is Neolithic nostalgia.
The aim remains the same, to personalise this ancient monument.
So a digital photo album is a great way to create almost a national photo album of Stonehenge.
He's got one, she's getting hers, and she's not leaving without one. Photographs, millions of them, taken of this extraordinary monument. And now this monument wants yours. Sue Lane was just 4 when she walked among the stones in 1966 and also came back to the same place. Whilst Jane Vellander was a little girl in the late 1960s on a visit from Bristol. And today she came back in person as well, to the very same stone, all to join a new project sharing personal memories of Stonehenge 100 years after the site was gifted to the nation.
I was about 5 and I vividly remember coming here and being wowed by how big the stones were and how old, even though I was only little.
The project wants any photo from anyone, from anywhere at Stonehenge. It's to tell the story of the past 100 years by the people who've been here. This is Neolithic nostalgia.
Stonehenge has about 1.5 million tourists a year, and everybody takes a photograph. With this new project, it doesn't matter how old the photograph is, or whether the picture's black and white or colour. The aim remains the same, to personalise this ancient monument.
Hundreds of photos have been uploaded, each one placed at the spot they were taken.
We want to make sure that there's an opportunity for people to share those special memories and those stories of Stonehenge's most recent history. So a digital photo album is a great way to create almost a national photo album of Stonehenge.
Archaeology meets photography in a unique digital album set in stone.